outer space. We're leaving Mother Earth to save the human race. Our Star Blazers! A cry for help, a desperate plight, makes our Star Force reunite as we rush to meet our fate. The Comet Empire awaits. We must be strong and brave to stop its evil ways. If Zordar's plot should work, he'll destroy the universe. We'll fight the Comet Empire, battle through the raging fire, filled with the hope that Earth will survive. We'll keep peace alive with our Star Blazers.
Dargo will pass our moon surface station in 30 minutes.
Sir, the Andromeda's left the Venus orbit and will be in firing range of the Argo at dawn tomorrow.
What is that?
Something blew up. One of our defense satellites exploded.
All by itself?
I heard one of our space cruisers took off without orders from the Defense Council.
Why would they do that?
I know what happened. The Star Force is up there doing something very important. My big brother's in the Star Force, and he knows what he's doing.
Megameters to moon orbit. Everything's okay. No one's chasing us. Skies are clear.
Guess they've given up trying to stop us.
No, we're still in the Earth's defense zone. They'll keep at it.
We're passing our moon station.
No word from our moon station. I wonder what they're up to.
Sandor, identify that formation of flying objects rapidly approaching.
Deck planes from our moon surface station.
Do you think they're on patrol or are they going to attack us?
I'm sure they know the Argo is up here without orders.
All hands to your combat stations.
Former Black Tiger Squadron Leader. Request permission to land on the Argo.
That is Conroy.
He's come to join us. Conroy!
Come on, man. Open up the deck and roll out the red carpet.
This is Pilot Hardy of the Moon Surface Air Station. Request permission to join the Star Force.
This is Pilot Bud of the 3rd Air Force bringing up the rear.
Conroy! Hardy!
Welcome aboard, Conroy.
How come you left us behind?
Well, you see, Conroy, we took off in kind of a hurry.
What'd you do, punch the commander in the nose, or just sock old General Stone?
Why did you think of that?
megameters to the Argo.
Speed, 24 space knots. There's no sign that the Argo's accelerating.
Captain, what do we do now? It's obvious the Argo's not going to return to Earth willingly. And three of our men from the moon surface base have deserted to join the Star Force.
I'm sorry, but we have orders to stop the Star Force. One way or the other.
I'm almost as glad to see your planes as I am to see you. We only had one astrofighter on board.
Just wait till you try the Numa. It's a winner.
Mine's a great little plane, and I just couldn't bear to leave her behind.
Ha, 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 ha Watch it. Now, we heard you were short-handed, Wild Star, but are you recruiting cats now?
Mimi is our mascot. She's going to bring us good luck.
Ooh. Here's to Mimi, the rescue cat.
Mimi, come back here. Wherever you're going, I'm sure it's against some regulation. Come back here. I'm your captain, and you're supposed to obey orders. Now listen. Hey, Nova, wait.
I am a member of the Star Force too, Derek. Now on duty.
You are not on our crew list, are you?
No, but...
It's my fault, Wildstar. In the rush of leaving, I forgot to do it.
You must leave the ship.
Huh?
I can't maintain discipline if we have people on board who ignore regulations.
Oh, come on, Wildstar. You don't mean that. Say, you're a fine one to talk about regulations. Or are you the only one who can break rules, even with a good reason?
What are you doing?
I'm leaving this ship.
What are you talking about? You know you can't get back to Earth from here.
Isn't that what you ordered me to do? I'll get back to Earth if I have to jump ship and swim through space.
Stop that right now. Put on your crew uniform and resume your duties as a member of the Star Force. I wanted you safe. Down on Earth, away from all this danger. I never wanted you to take this risk. It was too much to ask of you, too much.
I'm part of the Star Force, just as you are. I've earned the right to take the same risks you take. And I wanted to be with you and the others.
Nova.
The Argo has passed Mars orbit. Distance, 2,000 megameters.
Has she seen us yet?
No, sir. She is cruising at normal speed.
Captain, I think they feel secure since they've cleared the Earth defense zone.
Go full speed. We'll overtake her just before she reaches the asteroid belt.
Once again, the Argo bids goodbye to Earth.
What?
That's the Andromeda.
The Andromeda? She hit our radar blind spot.
Emergency! Emergency! All hands to combat station! Combat station!
2,000 meters! She's right behind us!
That close? Boy, we're in a tough spot.
Hey, Nova's here!
Lieutenant Nova, reporting for duty.
We missed you! Now the Star Force is really complete!
So you were with us!
Did you really think I'd let you guys leave without me?
A message from the Andromeda.
What?
It reads, Star Force, stop at once or we will stop you. Signed, Captain Gideon of the Andromeda. What's our answer?
There is no answer. Venture, can we shake off the Andromeda?
We can't do it. She's the fastest ship we have in our defense fleet.
Wildstar, remember the asteroid belt? We can hide in there.
That's the spot. Full speed.
The Argo is speeding up, sir.
That Wild Star. He thinks he can get away from us.
They're heading straight for the asteroid belt, where they think they can hide from us. It won't work.
Captain,
confirmed. Asteroid belt at 7 megameters, dead ahead.
Distance 1800 to the Argo.
How about a warning shot?
Forget it.
It's going to be a rough ride.
The Argo's going through that asteroid belt at her top speed. We just can't catch her.
I should have known it.
There's an opening, just big enough for the Argo.
Hang on.
I'm much too old for this sort of thing.
Come on, you guys. We need a lot more speed. Captain, we can't follow the Argo through there.
Where is it?
We've lost them in the asteroid belt. The asteroids are interfering with our radar.
Captain,
take it easy. They're going through the belt. All we have to do is go around before they come out and meet them on the other side. See?
No signs of the Andromeda. Maybe they're stuck in the asteroid belt. Or they've given up.
You did a nice job, Venture.
That was our toughest hurdle. We should be okay now. Right, Wildstar? Wildstar.
I don't think we should count on it, Venture. Captain Gideon is a very good officer. He won't give up. He has his orders. We're going to see the Andromeda again.
We're crossing Jupiter's orbit. We've just picked up a large ship on the radar.
What?
Put it on the video panel.
Andromeda?
Yes, it's the flagship Andromeda. She's advancing at slow speed.
She went around the asteroid belt.
Now what do we do?
Wildstar, why don't you have a talk with Captain Gideon?
What for? What do you think, Venture? Would Captain Gideon be interested in what we have to say?
Wildstar, give it a try. There's nothing to lose.
Captain Gideon's coming up on the screen.
Wildstar, I have just one word. Return. You are in serious violation of the rules. Return.
Captain Gideon, we're not leaving Earth as an act of rebellion. That mysterious message warned Earth of a great danger in space.
The Defense Council is considering the matter. The Star Force has no authority to investigate. You must return to Earth.
No, we will not return. We are going on.
I say it again. Return.
No, I must refuse.
You leave me no choice. I must follow my orders.
We are determined.
I'm sorry.
Wildstar?
Okay. I tried to convince him, but now we've got to get past him.
All hands to combat stations. All hands man your combat stations.
The Argo is coming ahead, Captain.
Captain Gideon, the Argo is not backing down.
All right. Prepare for combat. Alter course 180 degrees. Point all guns at the Argo.
Target, Argo bearing 180 degrees. Range 25,000. Vertical angle plus 2 degrees.
Thank you.
Andromeda. Distance 23,000 megameters.
Look at that. The Andromeda is preparing for a full-scale attack.
Open gun turrets number 1 and number 2. Target, Andromeda. Turret number 1, all set for firing. Turret number 2, all set for firing.
Distance 20,000. Within our effective firing range.
Secondary turret number 1, standing by for firing. Bow missiles, ready for firing.
Range, 15,000.
Wildstar, if we stay on this course, we'll collide with the Andromeda.
If we collide, we'll be too damaged to continue on our mission. That will be the end of it.
Shall we open fire?
Not yet.
Range, 8,000, 7,000, 6,000.
Captain, seek permission to fire.
Wildstar, you really mean it.
$1,500.
Wildstar.
Captain Gideon, why wait?
Degrees starboard, after the Argo.
Cancel that order. Let her go. I hope Captain Avatar taught you well.
Wildstar, you did it. You faced him down.
Guess we did.
We just picked up a message from the Andromeda to Earth headquarters.
Read it.
Expected encounter with the Argo not accomplished. Could not locate.
He said that?
I told you he was a decent guy.
And a message from the Andromeda to us. To Deputy Captain Wildstar and all the Star Force. Respect your courage and dedication. Regards, Gideon, Captain Andromeda.
Great captain.
The Argo has just passed Jupiter.
Leave her alone. She's not that important to us.
Naska, you're supposed to report to me on the Star Force.
Dislock.
Anything the Star Force does is important to me. That is understood. You report to me.
But Leader Dislock, how can you trouble yourself with anything as unimportant as the Star Force?
Naska, you do not know the Star Force. I have met them in battle, and they are a force to be reckoned with.
Oh, that Gamelan upstart. Who does he think he is? Prince Zordar will regret the day he gave him so much power. All he thinks of is the Star Force. Star Force. Who are they?
What will be the fate of the Star Force now? How can they survive against two enemies as powerful as Prince Zordar of the Common Empire and Deslok of Gamelon?
outer space, protecting Mother Earth to save the human race. Our Star Blazers! Danger lurking everywhere, but we know we've got to dare. Evil men with evil schemes, they can't destroy all our dreams. We must be strong and brave. Our home we got to save. We must make the fighting cease, so Mother Earth will be at peace. Through all the fire and the smoke, we will never give up hope. If we can win, the Earth will survive. We'll keep peace alive with our stars.